A very good afternoon to all, with respected ma'am and sir. I am Susmita Naik and now I am going to discuss about the topic elements of cost. But before going to discuss about the topic elements of cost, first we will remind that what do mean by cost. So cost is the value of money that has been used to produce something or deliver a service. Now we will discuss about the elements of cost. So, the elements of cost are those elements which constitute the cost of manufacture of a product. There are three major elements of cost, and these are materials, labor, and expenses. Material also again divided into two parts. One is direct material, another is indirect material. Labor also is divided into two parts, direct labor and indirect labor. Expenses also divided into two parts. One is direct expenses and another one is indirect expenses. So first we will know about the material cost. The cost of commodities and materials used by the organization is the material cost. And direct material cost is the all raw materials either purchased from outside or it is manufactured in the house. For example, we can take that milk is the direct material of all the dairy products like ghee, butter, etc. Wood and graphite is the direct material of pencil. Indirect material is the material which we will require to produce a product, but it is not directly identifiable and it does not form a part of a finished product. For example, we can take that the use of nails to make a table or boxes. Now we will know about the labor cost. So the cost of remuneration paid to the employees of the organization is the labor cost. Direct labor cost is refers to the amount which paid to the workers directly engaged in the production of the goods, or we can say that who are engaged in the factory. They are the direct labor. Indirect labor is what? Indirect labor refers to the amount paid to the workers who are indirectly engaged in the production of goods. For example, that the wages paid to the storekeeper, salary of works manager, accountant, or personnel department salaries, etc. Now we will discuss about the expenses cost. So expenses cost is the cost of services provided to the organization and the notional cost of the assets owned. Direct expenses are refers to the expenses that are specifically incurred by the enterprises to produce a product. Without incurring which expenses you cannot take place the production is the direct expenses. For example, that cost of machine or cost of equipment without which production cannot be possible. Indirect expenses. Indirect expenses refers to the expenses which cannot be easily identified or the expenses that are incurred by the organization to produce a product is the indirect expenses. For example, we can take rent, telephone expenses, insurance, lighting, etc. If we will add all the direct cost, mean direct material cost, direct labor cost, direct expenses cost, then we will get the prime cost. And if we will add all the indirect cost like indirect material cost, indirect labor cost and indirect expense cost, we will get the overheads. But what do you mean by overheads? So overheads refers to all the indirect materials, indirect labor and indirect expenses. Now we will read about the classifications of overheads. How many types of overheads are there? Normally there are three types of overheads. One is factory overhead, second one is office overhead and selling and distribution overhead. So factory overhead consists of all overheads cost incurred from the stage of procurement of raw material till the production of finished goods is the factory overheads. In this factory overheads, all indirect expenses are incurred like indirect materials such as consumable store, cotton waste, oils, lubricants, etc. Indirect labor like wages paid to the storekeeper, salary of works manager, etc. indirect expense like carriage inward cost, factory lighting, rent, insurance. These all are the factory overheads. Now we will read about the office or administrative overheads. We can say also it. So these overheads are consist of all overheads cost incurred for the overall administration of the organization. And this include the material, labor and the expenses like indirect material such as stationery item, office supplies, and indirect labor like account, salaries paid to account and administrative staff, directors remuneration, etc. Indirect expenses like telephone expenses, postage expenses, depreciation on office building, bank charges, rent. These are the office overhead. Now we will read about the selling and distribution overheads. So these overheads are consist of all overheads cost incurred from the stage of final manufacturing of finished goods till the stage of sale of goods in the market and collection of dues from the customers. All the indirect costs like indirect material such as packaging material and samples, these all are the indirect material cost. And indirect labor like salaries paid to the sales personnel, commission paid to sales manager, these are the indirect labor cost. And indirect expenses like carriage outward, warehouse charges, advertisement, bad debts, repairs and running of distribution van. So these all are the indirect material, indirect labor and indirect expenses which is include under the selling and distribution overhead. That's all about the elements of cost. And this is a overall summary of elements of the cost. Thank you.